Welcome one and welcome all to the People's Channel, Orchids for Dummies, a place where you can get your life. Now, this is Foul Pal Darrell speaking, and in today's video, we will be talking about repotting Phalaenopsis Orchids. Do you have to repot them out of those clear plastic containers that you purchase them in? The benefits of repotting them and what will happen if you don't repot them. Stay tuned. Welcome back, Foul Pals. So, first, as recommended by the American Orchid Society, the best time to repot your Phalaenopsis orchids is after it has bloomed. Now, you do have people that will repot it while it's in bloom. I will only do it if it's in a dire emergency. As far as if the complete pot looks like this, then I would go ahead and repot it where you see most of the roots are dead. As you can see, the moss is all green with spores in it. That's letting you know that this is no longer a good setup for this Phalaenopsis orchid. Now, this is not a result of overpotting or overwatering. It's a result of the media has broken down, and now the pH is not adequate, and so the nutrients is not even going to be absorbed, which is going to lead to a salt buildup, suffocating the roots. Okay, so we're not talking about how to care for sick Phalaenopsis. I'm just letting you see that, no, you want to go ahead and repot your Phalaenopsis orchid after it has bloomed. Because this orchid right here is a newer orchid in my collection. And as you can see, she has gone on to live her best life. Not even a setback. She just kept on moving and kept on trucking. Whereas I have more Phalaenopsis orchids that I left in the pot to do this experiment. And it was some good and some bad. From each orchid that I left in a pot, I had another orchid that I did repot. Now, like I said, want to reiterate to you, as according to the American Orchid Society, the best time to repot your Phalaenopsis orchid is going to be after it has bloomed. So right now, we want to leave it alone. That is going to be the best of care for new beginners, okay? Now, when your orchid is right here, this means you waited too long, okay? This was the experiment, honey. These is the results from the experiment. You waited too long, so now you have a lot of deficiencies in your orchid. It does not have a virus. It just needs to be repotted because these roots have rotted away, leaving this pot very acidic, okay? And if it is going to be acidic, it is not going to be obtaining nutrients, which in the past several months, I have not been fertilizing it because it was in a winter rest. Now, a nitrogen deficiency will also leave your Phalaenopsis orchid with a halted growth. That means that this leaf right here has been looking like this for a very long time. Now, stay tuned and I'll show you some more examples. Thanks for staying tuned. Now, these two orchids right here are very similar, which meaning that they are orchids that I either kept in a plastic pot or that I have repotted. As you can see, this is a completely different orchid with the very same scenario exactly to the T as far as how I fed it and everything. This is also an orchid that I did not foliar feed with that seaweed kelp, okay? So as you can see, the stunted growth, now you see the nutrients being pulled from the bottom leaves very quickly as it is now time for the Phalaenopsis orchid to come out of vegetative state. With no to little roots to obtain her nutrients, she is going to have these insufficiencies, these deficiencies, if you will. I'm sorry. Now, this Phalaenopsis right here is one that I have used organic fertilizers on. I have been fertilizing with nitrogen, which is my well-balanced fertilizer. I repotted it. And as you can see, again, she's living her best life. You can see that she did have some calcium deficiency, but she was sent to me that way. Okay? So, please, keep staying tuned, darling. These are two completely different Phalaenopsis orchids, okay? I just want to show you the comparison to a Phalaenopsis orchid that I've been fertilizing and using organic supplements as well. As you can see, living her best life, new root production, new leaves. You do see that stunted growth. That's a setback, okay? That's not the same thing as a nitrogen deficiency, okay? Now, when it comes to nitrogen deficiencies, you will see these bottom to leaves being pulled off as it is trying to maintain all of the new growth at the same time. She has a new leaf coming in out of there, okay? And a lot of new root production as well. So this is going to be the perfect time to pot your Phalaenopsis orchids. Now, if you want to know about the colors of Phalaenopsis roots and what roots to cut and leave off, you will have to stay tuned to a future video, okay, Phal Pals? So it had its pros and cons because these have been in containers like this for almost a year now. And to a certain degree, it gave me enough time to be able to learn certain things about them as they were orchids that I did not have to water or fertilize as much being in that sphagnum moss. Now, my orchids that I have replanted into different pots and used that orchiata bark, I am seeing very good production coming from them. They will be blooming for me anytime soon now. Even my mom orchid, I gave it to her in the same situation. Her orchids have roots growing all over as well. So I don't know if she is dropping bottom leaves, but when I saw it, it was still doing well. So that is the perfect time to go ahead and repot these Phalaenopsis. Now, let's say that you get them in the summertime. Now, from my research, what I have done with this experiment, if you get it during the summertime, it's in bloom during the summer, you could wait around in fall to see if it reblooms for you and leave it in the pot. And also in the winter, you would have to water it a lot less. So that is going to keep you from overwatering your Phalaenopsis orchids. So I would suggest to leave it in there until spring. That's when most people do their repots anyway. Give you plenty of time to go ahead and get the right pots. Give you plenty of time to get the right media and everything. So I hope this video helped someone out today. If it did, give it a like. Please comment. Let me know that you enjoyed it. And subscribe to the people's channel, Orchids for Dummies. Until next time.